In this video, we are going to see how to use the hash functions using the Python programming language. Generation of hash functions is very important when we are developing software in the current environment where the security is every time more important, and we need to have sure that information was not modified during some process or be able to validate the source of some information, or even to store information in database like a password without having the information stored with a clear text. Okay, so how to use the Python programming language for this purpose? It's actually very simple to program because there is already a native library named Hashlib. So you can just import that and use that. You don't have to program anything. So basically here we have some password that is in a string, but to use this hashlib functions, we need to encode our string to UTF-8. Okay, once it's encoded, then we can play with that. We then can call the MD5 function, that is a kind of algorithm for generate hash functions that produce hash with the size of 128 bits. So it generates the hash, give it to us one hash object. The hash object is not the hash string, it's an object. And then we can use its method to retrieve it, or as a byte array, or as a hexadecimal string, that's a typical representation for hash functions. Okay, and then we have some other metadata we can ask for these objects. For instance, what's the size, the digit size, so how many bytes this hash has generated. Okay, and then we can do that for several other hash algorithms, such as the SHA256. So it generates one hash with the size of 256, and then we can use in the same way as we use the MD5. The interface of the method is the same. We just call a different method. And there is another algorithm available using this hashlib. So let's run that and make one experience of how is its behavior. Right, so just put that above for we can see the output that we are going to print as long as the code is executed. And now we run that. Okay, it has minimized, and here it is. So in this first part is the way we can print bytes in the console. Bytes are not done to be printed directly, so we have this strange string. But actually, when we want to store the hash as a string, for instance, in a column in the database, we can generate that using this hash digits. So it's the same content, but formatted in a proper manner using a hexadecimal string. The size of this string is just 32 characters, where each character actually represents four bits because it's hexadecimal. So the string is composed of 16 bytes. So just multiply by 8 to have that in bit size. So 128, that's the MD5 hash size. Okay, and the same for the SHA256. Then we have the string with 64 characters that it use 32 bytes that multiplied by 8 gives us the size of the hash function in bits. So it's that for this video, one overview about how to use the hashlib function in Python programming language. You can download the source code using the link available in the video description. Thank you for watching.